Hi, in this video, let's try and understand, does every business need a thank you page to be there on the website? So thank you page is essentially a page once a user has finished the desired activity on the website, you guide them, the user, to a thank you page. So in case of an e-commerce website, the moment a user buys a product, the user is landed to a thank you page which says thanks for shopping with us. So what is the purpose of creating a thank you page? Can the website not survive without having a thank you page? So let's try and understand what is the importance of thank you page today. So thank you page, for quite a few years, have been a measure of a page to track conversions on the website. So typically what happens is, when you run campaigns, marketing campaigns, you've been implementing digital marketing activities across the world wide web. You have people landing onto your website through various sources, and you would eventually want to track which of those sources gives you higher returns. You would want to measure the ROI of each of those platforms. So typically what happens is, you run campaigns on Google AdWords. Google gives you a conversion tracking code which you would essentially add onto the thank you page. Facebook gives you a conversion code which you can add again to a thank you page. So that the moment a user who visits your website through Google AdWords or Facebook or any of these paid advertisement platforms and finishes a desired activity, which could be either a sale for an e-commerce or could be a lead for B2B websites or for businesses like us, we are a training institute, we would probably track the thank you page and say, okay, this conversion has happened because of Google AdWords or this conversion has happened because of Facebook. So conversion thank you page essentially had been there from a conversion tracking perspective. So yes, it should be there. However, it's not mandatory that you need to have a thank you page in order to track conversion, because that conversion can be tracked even on the click of the submit button. So it's all JavaScript, and the moment someone clicks on the button, on the submit button, the conversion tracking code could be triggered. So which means, not necessarily I need to have a thank you page from a conversion tracking perspective. But however, it is always recommended to have a thank you page from a reason that it's not only the JavaScript that you're trying to trigger it's not only the JavaScript through which you're trying to track the conversion, but what also a lot of bigger brands do, the bigger e-commerce guys, they also pass a lot of parameters in the URL, which is typically it could be xyz.com/thank you? And then you would see a lot of parameters. Of course, a lot of them would be encrypted for the business to understand what the XYZ would mean or an ABC would mean. So maybe this XYZ could refer to a product, or an ABC could refer to the overall cart size that the person would have ended up buying on the e-commerce website. And of course, this ID could be tracking of the user in the database. So yes, thank you page is needed because you pass a lot of parameters in the URL to track the user behavior. You can track the sales, you can track the user behavior, you can track the source and whatever activity that the user has done on the website. So from that perspective, yes, thank you page is needed. Now, I think in the current day scenario, thank you page would be more important than purely tracking a conversion. And where it would be used is in cross-selling and upselling. So let's try and understand what's happening here. So for a minute, let's move out of the online system and go to the offline system, wherein you walk into a retail store, and the moment you're about to pay at the counter, you have those small bunch of products which are kept around at the payment counter so that you can just pick them up. So that's a last minute push to try and see if the overall ticket size of the basket could be added by a few rupees or so. But the similar logic is not applied online. The moment you are about to pay on the payment gateway, there's no pop-up which comes as an offer and says, okay, there's a special offer for you for today or whatever. For a reason that does not happen online is, the point of time the user is about to pay, you would not want to distract the user with an offer, so that the offer might confuse the user and might take the user back to the website. So you let that transaction happen. So let the transaction happen and let the user come through the page, through the thank you page. The moment the user is at the thank you page, now that's where you can try to cross-sell and upsell a product. So let's say if I was an e-commerce company and I was selling mobile phones and the user has just bought a mobile phone, not bought any of the accessories. The moment the user lands out of the thank you page, maybe I customize an offer for accessory and try to see if I can extend the sale from mobile phone to also an accessory, which is I could, the moment the user finishes the transaction, moves out of the thank you page, there's an offer which says we have a special offer of XYZ percentage on this accessories for you, and the offer is valid for the next 10 minutes. Since you've already made a purchase with us, we have some of your data already saved. So would you want to confirm buying an offer, buying this accessory at a discounted price? So out of 100, maybe few people could do that. And that's where you can try your chances to upsell yourself. And sometimes it could also be cross-selling. Now cross-selling is, okay, you bought a, let's say, you've applied for a real estate, you've applied for a real estate, filled an inquiry form, and the moment you finish out of your thank you page, there's a pop-up, okay, would you also need a home loan assistance because we have a tie-up? So that's a cross-selling, saying that, okay, this person is buying a flat, so he might also be interested in a home loan, or maybe cross-selling something else. So thank you page could be an excellent opportunity for you to upsell and cross-sell your product. What happens is, with the businesses where you generate leads, the sale does not happen online. So that thank you page could be an excellent place to start lead nurturing, which is the moment the person has inquired for a product or service and not ended up as a sale, you could start with a lead nurturing process. So for an example, let's say if in our case, what we could do is the moment user finishes filling the lead form and exits out of the thank you page, after we've done the tracking, what we might say, okay, we have few videos or few paid content which is available for you free, and you can use this code and use the content. So that's like building a relationship, and that could be the beginning of a lead nurturing process so that we can eventually build this relationship to an acquisition stage. So thank you page today is not necessarily only for conversion tracking, but it's also about cross-selling and upselling. It's also about beginning of a lead nurturing process. But then what's crucial here is the offers has to be dynamically generated. Depending on what the user has done on your website, the upselling, cross-selling, or the lead nurturing process has to be dynamically generated so that it's customized for every individual. And the chances of falling for the offer could be maximized. So that's where I think thank you page should be used today.